Welcome back guys. So in this video I will explain you whatever concept I have explained previous to this video, where I was talking about how we should insert the data at the beginning, how we should insert the data at the end, and how we should insert the data at the middle, right? So beginning, end and middle I have already explained. Now let me show you how to do that through the code and how we should write the code. So guys, first try to understand. In linked list, first again, let me draw the diagram and let me explain you. So when you talk about the linked list, guys, what happens in case of linked list? So this is your node, right? This is your node, and let's say this is your second node, right? And your linked list has only two node, just for explanation, and this will point to null, right? You got it. Now every node, you have two section. One is, let's say, data, so I'm saying that 5, and the second node I'm saying that data, which is nothing but 10, right? Now this guy has the address of second node, so second node address is equal to, let's say, 200. So 200 will be here, right? So actually, if you try to understand, this node is nothing but object, as I was mentioning earlier. So if you look at here, guys, this node class has two constructor. One is default and one is parameterized, right? Now if I have to create the object, how do I create the object? I will write like this. I will write list node li is equal to new list node, right? And inside that I will supply 5. So what will happen? One node will get created, 5 will assigned here, right? And in beginning, so when I will create the first node, you know how it will look like? It will get created like this. Let me explain you. It will get created like this. It will be 5, and here this will be pointing to null, right? You understood why it will be pointing to null? Because when you say 5, this 5 will come here, and your data will get initialized with the 5, but your class has one more field called class type. So the class type default value is the null, right, which is nothing but next. So your object, right, your object, this li object has data is equal to 5, and this is equal to null. So this is the first node. Now again you will go and you will create the second node. So when you will create the second node, you know what will happen? Let's say, let me write one more node. So let's say I will write like this, list node L2 is equal to new list node, let's say 8. Assume that this is second object I have created. Now when I will create the second object, and I need to insert the node at the beginning, so right, so when you, the moment you will create the second object, logic wise forget here, I'm not explaining logic here, I'm trying to explain you why we need this. Okay, I'm trying to explain you, right? Data you might be understood very easily, because data is very simple. Here what happens when I will created one more node? So guys, now understand here. Now this is my first node, which was there already, right? Now I have created one more now, which is now 8, and this guy is pointing to null. This guy is also pointing to null, right? If you look at this guy, next is also pointing to the null. So generally what happens, since I am adding one more node, my first node will point to the second node. What is my second node? You look at here, what is this guy? This guy is what? This guy is the object, right? This guy is the object. The entire things, if you look at the entire things, it is object of type what? List node. It is of object of type list node, right? So basically, if I have to explain you, this is going to be L2 here. Okay, and there will be a connection. The moment you will write L2 here, there will be a connection. So when you will write L2 here, which is nothing but list node, right? What is the type of L2, guys? So if you look at the type of L2 here, the type of L2 basically is going to be, let me change the color now. So the type of L2 here, this type, okay, this is going to be a list node, right? What is the type of L2? List node. So what is the next type should be? It should be list node, right? That is the reason I have written here list node, because L2 you are storing here, right? So when you are storing L2, L2 type should be of list node. Now it is crystal clear. This is the first node, this is the second node. When you connect them, first node will have the reference of second node L2, and the L2 type should be of list node, right? So your next should be of type list node. I hope that it is crystal clear here. There should not be any doubt in this class. And then getter and setter, guys, you know that this will help you to get the data and to set the data, nothing else, right? To get the data, to set the data. So this is all about, you know, list node, right? Like how do you create a node? How do you, you know, why we write? Why we write two fields? Why we write data and list node next? So it is clear here. Now, people will ask you, you know, you need to go and you need to design the list node. Like how do you convert the same thing into a code? So let me erase this and then I'll explain you what I will do that, right? So for now you are clear with the list node. Now how do you insert in the beginning of the node? Let's erase this. Okay, so now try to understand, you are going to write a logic where you need to always insert the data into a beginning. So how do you do that? First try to understand, then you know we'll go with the programming part, right? To go with the programming part, first we need to understand how we should design. So assume that this is your first node. Okay, this is your first node. You have data is equal to 1. This guy is pointing to null. Very first node, right? When you insert very first node, that's how it will be. And this node head will be pointing to this node, right? Now let's say you need to add second node. So when you'll add the second node, guys, so let's say this is my second node. Data is equal to 5. This guy is pointing to null, right? This is my second new node. So here the requirement is you need to insert at the beginning. So how do you do that? To insert in the beginning, whatever you have inserted as a second node, that should be a first node. Because in reality, how this should be, you know, 5 should come here, right? Because you have to always insert at the beginning, and this guy next should point to this node, and this should point to the null. And basically head should point here, right? Head should point here. That's where you are going to insert in the beginning, right? You are not going to insert at the end. Now third node, let's say somebody will insert the third node. So again, if I have to insert the third node, let's say 3, and this guy is pointing to null. So this I have to insert in the beginning. So basically head should, you know, head somehow should point here, right? And this, the third node, whatever we have it here, dot next should point to 5. So basically how it is, it should look like this. So the third will come here, third next 5 will point, and 5 next 1 will point, right? And head will come here by design. That's where you are going to insert in the beginning. You are trying to understand here now, right? It is clear. Now how we should write a logic. So logic part is very, very important, where we need to understand how we should approach the logic. So let's see that how we will do that. So let me just erase this. In beginning, I will go very slow, guys, because this is a very new topic. You are going through first time. It will take some time to understand, right? So let's say very first node I'm going to insert. So what I have to do, I have to create, there should be one method, right? There should be one method. Now look at here this method. This is very simple method. Insert at the beginning, and I will tell you why I have written like this, right? This method, what it will take? It will take one list node. You can see that it will take one list node, right? So as I explained, the list node has two things. One is data, one is the next, right? So let's say this method will take list node. So let's say you have created very first list node, and your list node is like this. This is your first node. This is pointing to null, right? Very first node you were supplied to this. So your new node came, okay? And when your new node will come here inside this, as of now head is not pointing to this new node, okay? As of now head is not pointing to this node. It is just a node. You have just created one object of the list node. And when you create the object of the list node, I have explained, you will have a data and next will be pointing to null. As of now head is not pointing here. So somehow we have to write a logic where head should point here, right? Head should point here to the first node, right? Which means now the class where I am writing the insertions, there should be one variable called, there should be one variable called head, right? There should be one variable called head, then only we'll be able to achieve that. So you can see that there is one variable called head. Okay, in beginning, when you create the object of this class, this linked list class, right, you can see that this class has only one constructor, right? This class has only one constructor, which means head will be in slice to null in the beginning. Head will be in slice to what? Head will be in slice to null, right? Because there is no other constructor apart from one constructor. So, and through this constructor, I'm not in slicing the head. So what I have to do, since this is my first node, I have to write a logic. Whatever my first node I have, you can look at here, node dot, which is nothing but this node what you supplied. So node, whatever node you have, dot set next is equal to head, right? So how it will happen? This is my node. So this is my node is equal to 1 dot set next. Set the next is equal to head. So in the beginning, head will be what? Head will be null. So the next is going to be null for the first node. Then head is equal to node. Why head is equal to node? Because this node head should point to the first node. So now head will point here. You got it? Head will point here. Assume that first node is inserted, and you are calling this method multiple times. Through Eclipse also I will explain you, okay? You might be wondering why I have written this first line. There is a meaning for that. I'll explain you. Now let's say second node came, okay? Second node came. You have actually designed one more node called node is equal to 3. This guy is pointing to null, right? So you call this method with one more node, and this method job is whatever node you will call, it will insert at the beginning. So this was the first node. This is the second node. You again, you are calling this method with the list node, and this is nothing but list node. So it will come inside. So what actually, now you think logically, okay? Do not go with the code. Now this node, whatever you have, this node dot next, okay? This node next should point to this. Then only this will go to the beginning, right? Technically, this part, second node dot next should point to the first node. Then only this is going to be the second node, this is going to be the first node, and this head should point here, right? To do that, now you can understand why I have written like this, okay? Now the node is equal to 3. So basically what will happen, you know, here this 3 dot set next is equal to head, and what is the head? Head is equal to this node, right? So this will point to 1, right? Clear? And as of now head is pointing to the 1, right? So head we have to bring back to the third, right? So second line, head is equal to node, and what is the node? 3 is the node second time. So head will point here, you got it? And this guy will point to the null. Now one more node I have to add. Let's say node I have to add, node is equal to, I have to add 4, right? So again, think now what you have to do. So this again 4 should come here, right? 4 should come here and head should point to the 4, right? As of now, head is pointing to the 3. So whatever new node you have, new node dot set next is equal to head. Head is nothing but 3. So this is going to be, if you'll come here, this is going to be the 4, this is going to be the 3, and these things is already pointing to the 2, right? So this is already pointing to the 2, and then as of now head is pointing here, right? Head is pointing here as of now. So we have to cut this, right? So head is equal to node, right? And what is the new node? 4, which means head will point here, right? Head will point here. Length is plus plus is just for, you know, I'm counting that how many nodes are getting inserted. So you understood how you should insert in the beginning, right? Now you might be thinking why I'm doing like this, okay? What is the need of node dot set next is equal to head? Because, you know, sometimes this comes to the mind that why we should do like that. So let me tell you why we should do like that, like why we should do that net dot set next, right? Assume that, okay? Now try to understand. You did, this is your very first node, okay? Your data is equal to 1, right? And this guy is pointing to null. This is very first node, right? Now you might be thinking, why this guy is writing that, you know, this is, let's say this is node, right? So you are thinking that why I'm doing that node dot set next is equal to node dot set next head, okay? And then, you know, so if you look at the design, by design, how I am trying to do that, node dot, I am writing that set next is equal to head, and then I am doing that head is equal to node, right? That's how I am doing that, right? So there is a reason for that, why we should do, you know, node dot set next is equal to head. There is a reason for that, because let's say when second node come here, think about the second node. Second node came here, second node is pointing to n. So we are writing a logic where the second node should go before first node, right? Now let's say when you don't do this, let's say if you erase this point, so for the first node it will work fine, because, you know, when you'll call this method insert at the beginning, for very first node it will work fine, because, you know, it will go here, one will be here, this next will point to null. And let's say you don't have this line, you should not write this line. Let's say you have not written that, you're just writing that head is equal to node, so it will point here. Head will point here. So for first node it will work fine. Think about the second node. So you have inserted one more node. Now two you have to insert. So by design, by expectation, two should come here and the next should point to here, right? And this guy should point to null by design, and head should come here, right? And assume that you have not written this line, first line, node dot set next head, you have not written, you have just written head is equal to node, okay? What will happen here in such cases? The moment you will insert second node, you know what will happen? Second node will do actually head is equal to node. So head is equal to node, which means your second node, whatever second node we have, the head will point here. So head will point here, right? Head will point to the second node, right? But there will not be any connection to the first node, right? There will not be. So with this, head will point to the second node, but then there is no connection with the first node. How do you connect this first node, right? You got it? We will not be. That is the reason whatever head is pointing in the beginning, okay, first the node, whatever new node you are going to insert, the second node dot set next, the set next should point to the head. So first we should create the connection. So when you have the first line, this guy will create the connection here, and this guy next will point to one, okay? Now node dot set next is equal to head. So the first line is the one which will create the connection whenever there is a new node is coming, and then you write head is equal to node, which means it will get changed here, right? You got it? That is the reason the first line is very, very important. With this, I'll close the video. In next video, I'll see that some more concept of the linked list. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this.